British Columbia has 25,000 kilometers of coastline, islands, and inlets. Perhaps this is why our city has become a world center for submarine research and development, revealing the mysteries of life under the water. Our next guest is a National Geographic Explorer who is inspiring young girls to play a role in this emerging industry. Please welcome Erika Bergman.
I know what you're thinking. Girl walks on stage with a microphone and something under a sheet. I hope it's a ventriloquism. I'm just kidding. Nobody ever thinks that. Hi, I'm Erika, and I am your friendly local neighborhood submarine pilot. I have the very great privilege in my life of getting to do something extraordinary, and I don't take a single day for granted. I just want to get that out there. Our world underwater is incredible. And you remember when you were a kid and you would look at those pictures of Don Walsh and Jacques Picard with their face smashed up against the window of a submarine and their eyes kind of bugged out and they're looking at something. I saw that picture when I was a kid and I was like, there's no way that it's that cool. I'm never gonna look all smashed up against the window of a submarine. Then I found this beauty. So here in British Columbia, I'm the submarine pilot for Aquatica Submarines, and this is our girl Stingray 500. It's a 500-foot capable submersible, and as you might notice, the water of Howe Sound is this phenomenal, elegant, emerald green color. We have the very great privilege of living in a place with an extraordinary ecosystem. I know you look out into the water and it looks like this opaque, dark surface, but when you descend below the surface, all of the sudden this enormous world swirls up in front of you, and it's green and it's gray and it's blue and it's mixing all the time. You look out this giant window in any direction and it's like looking at this camouflage, and the mixing of the water looks like heat radiating off of a hot tarmac. The stunning thing about the place we live is how many different ecosystems it supports, but not only that, how many of those ecosystems support us. The first time you go underwater, the first thing you realize is that the ocean isn't blue. It's orange and it's yellow, it wiggles, it stings, it's got teeth, it's got all kinds of goofy stuff going on, and we had no idea. It's only when you actually submerge under the water and you start looking at these environments, you realize even though the creatures in the ocean are this big often, we are actually the smallest part of planet Earth. We have Mars and the moon 100% mapped. So here's what this looks like. If you took this room tonight and you put it on the surface of the moon, I could count the number of people sitting in here. That's how well we have it mapped. That's the resolution. If you took the Vancouver Playhouse and you put it on Mars, I could walk the blocks down the street and identify this building. If you took downtown Vancouver and you put it on the bottom of the ocean, you would have no idea it was even there. The world is enormous. And we have the very great privilege of being its explorers. Somehow we've lost this sense of the world still needing explorers. Oh, it's all been done before. Everybody's been to the North Pole, South Pole, every mountain, Everest, Kilimanjaro, everything. You know where nobody has been? 95% of the ocean. They could have your name on it. This is my rock. I found this rock. I'm going to plant a tiny flag. The ocean, it's incredible to get to work down there. I love what I get to do. So, would you like to go on a dive? All right, the first thing we do is we close the hatch. Make sure no tacos the night before, everyone. Once you close that hatch, there's no air in, there's no air out. Clean socks, please, no tacos. You close the hatch, and you hear the pilot on the comm, topside, topside, Stingray. Hatch is closed and dogged. Life support systems are on. We're ready to dive, dive, dive. Cue video, please.
Erika, we're ready to dive?
Yeah, we couldn't be more excited.
Oh my God, so cool!
Everything you saw in that video was right here. We have sharks, really, really big ones. They're called six-gill sharks. We have these crazy yellow things. I know, the coolest animal you've ever seen. They're called sponges. I know, you're so excited. Me too. Sponges are one of the oldest animals on planet Earth. So little is known about them, we don't even know how old a single individual sponge might be. They're beautiful, and they're weird, and they're kooky, and they've got all these things hanging off of them, and they look like trumpets that millennia have just been, gravity has just been working on them forever, and it's because gravity has been working on them forever. It's cool down there. It's amazing to get to be an explorer, and the best part of my job is getting to share stories of the incredible things that we see. I don't want to be alone down there. We need more explorers. So I noticed that the more and more I started telling submarines, the more and more little ponytails would start circling around. I was like, "This, I'm not doing enough. Telling stories isn't enough. I need to do something more." So I invented this thing called Girls Underwater Robot Camp. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Where I teach girls how to build robots that go underwater at camp. Girk. Fun to say, fun to do. So no, it's not a ventriloquism dummy. This is what the girls build. I just wanted to give you guys a brief little look. This is a super high intense engineering program. They build, they learn how to solder, they learn how to weld, but they learn the most important thing, which is how to join us in the field as explorers so that they can one day become submarine pilots. Thank you.